Hello friends and good day. This is Fred with Tech Talk and I'm coming at you today with a video on how to employ Tripwire technology with your Dahua IP camera, NVR or DVR. This is a very cool technology. My personal opinion is it is more effective than motion detection. But what you can do is set up predefined zones indicated by these blue rectangles. And when an object passes through this zone, it will trigger a tripwire alarm event that will be notified to your phone or laptop through email. It's very cool technology. When the alert comes through to your email, it will just say IPC message like this. And when you double click it, you will get a snapshot of what caused the tripwire alert. Okay, you see a truck passing here. Here we see a fellow walking. It could be a variety of things. We find this very effective because oftentimes with motion detection, unless you have an SMD smart motion detection camera, weather, trees moving, stuff like that in the environment will set off false alarms with motion detection. Whereas with Tripwire, we found it only activates when a vehicle or person actually goes through that zone. It's a very cool tool. We're going to cover it right now. All right, let's get into the meat and potatoes. Before we do, you know the drill. There is a red subscribe button in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. Please click that and subscribe to our channel so you'll be notified when we upload future content. Also, like the video if it's useful to you. And as always, leave comments. A lot of these videos are based on subscriber question and comments. So yes, these IP cameras, as you can see, are already networked to the Smart PSS app by Dahua. There's a link going across the top of your screen right now that will walk you through the steps of attaching or connecting a IP camera to Smart PSS or an NVR or DVR. It's the same process. This video really is not about that. It's about the Tripwire technology. So to get caught up to this point, if you need to connect your devices to Smart PSS, go ahead and do that now. You can also pull them up through a browser. Okay. So what we're going to do, we're going to pull up one of these cameras in a browser and I will show you how to set up this Tripwire zone. Okay. Using Smart PSS is very simple. We're just going to go to the device config tab right here. We're going to pick our camera. Okay, so we can pick entrance here. And we're gonna pick link to web. Okay, and what that's going to do is open my camera in a browser, as you can see right here. And I'll put in my password. Okay, there is the picture. What we want to do is define our tripwire zone. So we're going to go to settings. If you look right here, you will see a tab marked settings. We're going to go to event. Okay, just click on event. And one of your options is IVS. Before we do IVS, we want to click on smart plan and make sure that is enabled. Okay, by default it will be off. We want to click on it, it will turn yellow, and that will enable smart planning, which is part of IVS. So now we can click on IVS and we can create that tripwire alarm. As you can see on this camera, I've already done that. When you log into a camera yourself for the first time, there'll be nothing here. There'll be no predefined rule. Okay, so you're going to hit this green plus. Okay, it's very simple. And you can see you've created rule one, which is a tripwire. We're just going to draw that rectangle, okay? You do so with your mouse, I'm left clicking right now, and I'm just dragging to this area. Now I'm gonna come over here, just drawing a rectangle, right? When I'm done, and you made your rectangle, you just right click with your mouse, and you'll see the arrows. Okay, so anything passing through this now is going to cause a tripwire alarm that is emailed to me. Okay, we need to enable send email right here. okay? And if you want the camera to pre-record the event, you can hit here, okay? We just want the snapshot emailed to us, so we're gonna do that. The reason I just do the snapshot, if it's something I'm interested in through the snapshot, I can do playback and see the whole entirety of the event. 10 seconds before, 10 seconds post delay, that really doesn't do anything for me. I just want to be alerted what's going on. And if that is of interest to me, again, then I can go and do playback. So we've enabled email and we've enabled snapshot, and we are going to save. Okay. Obviously, for this to work, you will have to have the SMTP settings set up in the camera, so it knows who to email. Okay. If we go to the network tab right here, you will see SMTP email. Okay. There is a link going across the top of this screen that will teach you how to enable SMTP outgoing emails with a Dahua recorder using Gmail. Okay. Again, we're not going to cover all of that in this video, but basically you just put your outgoing SMTP server information here, the port it uses, and your credentials, your username and password for that account, a sending address that the emails from the camera will be coming from, and the recipient email, okay? Just like that. Once you have these in place, you can do a test, and it will tell you if your account has been set up successfully. There we see succeed, and it has been, okay? So again, please refer to that video for setting up the SMTP email notification portions of this, okay? But that's it. It works beautiful. I don't know if there is anybody on site now that may trip a tripwire, so you can see what that looks like. All right, here we go. Here we have a truck approaching the tripwire, and right there, you will see it's green as it approaches the tripwire. When it hits the tripwire, it activates the alarm, which is red, and that is when the email will be notified. You'll see the timestamp here, 10:11. When we are finished this demonstration, we'll go into our email and actually find this tripwire alert. Okay, this is playback. When he gets out of the zone, you'll see the truck again will turn green. There it goes. So that's how this works. Very cool. Again, it eliminates the false alarms caused by motion detection. Unless you have a more expensive SMD, smart motion detection camera, that detects only humans and vehicles. When it's a windy day, these trees would set off it. Also, heavy storms in the Northeast. You see we have snow here. If it's a blizzard and we have lots of snow, with motion detection, the snow can actually set off the alarm. Here, it needs to be a person or vehicle going across the tripwire. So, let me show you that email from 10:11. 10:11, right here. There's that truck approaching the other camera. Let's see if it's this one. Yep, that's what we saw right there at 10:11:11. So this would be the email alert that you get to your phone. Okay, just says IP, a message, alarm event, tripwire, channel 1. Okay, 10:11. Perfect. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Again, very useful tool. Hopefully this stuff is helping you out. We'll see you in the field.